Hello and welcome to Kimber Bushcraft, and welcome to my series Bushcraft from A to Z in random order. And as I said in the previous video, today it's about the letter S and it's about stoves. So as you saw, I brought all my stoves with me and I would like to tell you a little bit about them, the pros and the cons and so on. And I hope you like, so hang on. And this is the first stove I'm going to tell you about. This is from Trankia, a Swedish company that makes very good stoves. And this stove is one I use when I'm on camping with my family. It can take a big pot and I can cook over here for several persons. It is gas stove. I can screw this off and on, and it's actually very easy to assemble. You just take this one off. This is the actual burner that is inside this little pot, and I can take them apart and put them together, and that way it is very compact. This stove I have had for many years, probably 30 years, and it's done well all the time. The only thing is when it's very cold, it's a little bit difficult to use gas. But this one has this one up, heats the gas, so it's much more easier to get the fire. But this stove is a working horse, and with these large gas cans, I have cooking time for very long time. So this is my first stove I would like to show you. It's aluminium, and well, the price is okay. It's not cheap, but it's quality, so I can definitely recommend you to buy this if you're going for the gas. Another stove that I have from the gas is this one, this little stove that I bought some years ago. It's a more compact stove, as you can see, and I can screw this off so I can have the gas separate, and then I can put this one in a little bag that is comes with this little burner. And this little burner is also very efficient and can cook a lot of food on this. It's not as good as the big Trankia, but this is good, and especially if you are on a hike, you can bring this along at the that way you have a very compact system that you can use, and it's very easy to use. The pros about gas is they are clean and they are very easy to maintain, and these gas canisters you can buy all over the world. So that's the pros. The con is if you run out of gas, then you have no other option for cooking your meal or your water, boiling your water, sterilize it. So you have to be sure to have a lot of gas with you. But and the other little thing is when it's very cold, this gas has problem with burning. So but again, gas stoves is a very good solution if you want something that works every time. Only if it's cold, it has a little bit problem. Then I have this little stove that I have made myself. In a minute I will show you how it works. And this is for alcohol. I got a little triangular burner here, and when I put that and this on top, I have a platform that I can cook on. And alcohol is very versatile. You can use that even if it's very cold, and it burns slowly but steady. And it's a good source for cooking your food. It's not so quick, so if you're going to boil a lot of water in a hurry, this is not good for that, but for ordinary cooking and making coffee, this is quite good. I don't use alcohol much. In the beginning I used this, but well, you have to bring alcohol with you, and if you are running out of that, again you have a problem. So but Trankia makes those very cool burners, and You just screw this off and put the alcohol down here, and then you light it. It's very easy. And when it's done, you just take this one up and place it over it. And then it kills the fire. So, but this little thing I made myself. I have these on top so that the pot will have enough space to the flame. And then I have, yeah, this way. Yeah, and then I have a little leather string that I could put in these holes that I made. And these holes are made for the airflow to the burner. It burns more efficient that way. And then I take these and put them here and just tie a knot. Perhaps two. And this is a very compact system. I made it from aluminium again, and with this little burner you have a little compact system that you can bring with you, and that you can cook your food over. I think it's cool, and I have used that several times in the beginning when I was bushcrafting on YouTube. Perhaps you can see that there. And then I have this stove, and actually it's not my stove, it's my colleague who has made this for himself. He's also a little bit bushcrafting. And this stove can be, you can use small pieces of wood, or you can even put your Trenchlia burner down there, so it's a alcohol stove. He made this from something he bought at IKEA, and I know a lot of videos are out there how you make these. He put some small legs on, so it's raised from the ground and more stable, and I think it's cool. And he says that it burns very well, and when he stick these wood pegs in, you can see it is easy to have something on top of it. And actually he has this one. This is a little pot that he has bought especially for this little stove that he made. And I put a link below to where this pot, what the name is and where you can buy it. And the most cool thing about this is that you can take this off, put it down here, and then you have a reasonably compact stove that you can bring with you. So my good friend and colleague Ole made this, and he asked me if I would like to have it in my serious bushcraft from A to Z, and of course I will that. Thank you very much, Ole. You're a kind man. I also put a link to IKEA, so you can see where you can buy these. You can make that these models from two sizes, I think. This is the small one. You can buy one that is larger. And the pros about this stove is that it's very cheap to make, and it's very lightweight. I think it's stainless steel, and also compact. You can bring it, especially if you have this with you. You have a compact system. The cons is you have to be able to make these, and well, it's a little bit thin in the material, so you can, if you're unlucky, these will bend and perhaps break. But again, a good solution. And now to my box stove. These are all from Bushcraft Essential. I think they are very nice and very cool, and you can fold them down. I'll show that in a minute. I'll just take this one first. This was the first I bought, and I haven't used it a lot. I think it's too small. It's stainless steel, and you can pull it apart, and that way it's very compact. But I think it's difficult to assemble because of these, the way that it is made. Sometimes I have very great difficulties in assembling this, so I haven't used that a lot. But again, it's very compact and small, and you can have it with you all places, and there's even a little bag for this. But I think it is too small, even for one person. You have to feed this all the time, and well, it gives me a little stress if I can't sit and relax and just enjoy. So this one I would not recommend, unless you're going on a quick hike, a quick cup of coffee and so on. But this is something I haven't been using for many years. And then there are these stoves, and they are exactly the same, except this one is stainless steel and this one is titanium. And there's a little bit difference regarding the weight. Of course, the stainless steel is heavier than the titanium, but again, if you're going old school, that doesn't matter anything. You know all that old school gear is heavy. But this one I bought myself some years ago, and this one I got from Bushcraft Essential to try it out, and it's really cool. And you can see the color is has changed a lot, and that's the way titanium works. Something I noticed about the titanium model is that is a little bit when it has heated up, the metal is wobbling a little bit, and it's the bottom is not more totally flat, and this one is more stable and keeps the form, the shape, even after many burns, while this one changes a little bit in the shape, and is a little bit rounded in the bottom now. But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter at all, because it's only for putting your wood down here. Just see this, and I fold it in like that, and these one can be attached down on the back like these, so it's very compact. And of course there's a little pouch for this too. I love these stoves, and at the moment those of you who are following me closely know that this is my favorite stove at the time, and the reason for that is because it gives me a more feeling of a little bonfire, because the flames are reasonably high, and when I sit next to this, I feel a little bit more old school. I love this stove, and I think I'll use it for a long time now, and bring it with me. It's very compact. The pros are it's lightweight, it's compact, and you can use wood pellets, you can use small sticks, and you can even put your alcohol burner inside this and use it as a alcohol burner in that way. And on top of this, you can see there's a little grill you can buy and put on top, so you can use it when you are preparing your steaks or sausages and so on. So a very nice product from Bushcraft Essential. I love it very much. And then there are these kind of stoves. I have three of them, and I would like to tell you about them individually. And I'll start with this one. This stove is from a company called Pirulino. I made a video, a review about this stove, and I put a link below so you can see that review. Many of my viewers, subscribers, wrote in the comment section that they think it is too high, and I agree with them. The reason why it's made so high is because they have made a special kind of burning. It's very clean burning, and if you're using this, your kettle won't be salted in the bottom. It will be totally clean, and you can also use this for adjusting the airflow. so you can have it high and low, and that's really cool. But there's no problem with the stability, but it is high. If you compare it with my solo stove, it's actually double the size. And of course, if it's heavy wind, perhaps you can risk that it's turning over. I don't think so, but many of you have had these thoughts. So then I made an adjustment, I customized this a little bit. I'm not sure that Pirulino think it's a good idea, but I had to try it. So I actually cut this off so I can put this on here. And now you have a stove that is more compact and not as high. And it still works, and it works good. You can see here inside, there's something like that makes the flame which rotates, and when you are taking this off, it's not as clean as before. There's a little bit soot here. You can still use this for the airflow, high and low. It's not as efficient, but it still works, and it can easily be taken off, this one, and you can put your small twigs in here, your wood pellets, and it's a very efficient burner, and it has a button, so there won't be any sparks that will fall down on the ground. And with this little these three legs, it's very stable, so it's a good stove. The pros is you have a very clean burn, and reasonably compact, and you can use this for high and low flames. It's actually not, something I haven't seen in other stoves. The cons is that it's still very high, and it's not as compact as the other stoves I have. But this is a good little stove. I haven't used it much, mostly because the height of it, and because it's bigger than the other stoves I have. But great little product, and it's made in Greece, I think. And then I have this little stove, one I got from one of my subscribers, Lixada. It's not long ago that I made a review of this, showed you how you can use this. It's very compact. It's actually the most compact one of all my stoves here. And if you take this one off and put it down, you can see it's very compact. So it's a cool stove, and actually have a little bowl, so you can use it with alcohol as an alcohol burner. And that's really great too. And of course you can use wood pellets, as I did in my little test of it, and you can use twigs as in the other stoves. This stove is very good. It's a great product, a good quality, and it's stainless steel and very lightweight. I love this very much. The only cons I can see is that it has no button. So when I fire up this, the sparks, the small twigs that are burning will be on the ground, and if the ground is very dry, you can risk that you're starting a fire. So be careful when you use this. Perhaps you can place it over a stone or another surface that won't burn, and then you have a safe system. It's a great little stove, and it's one of the very good pros is that it's cheap, and you can buy it on, I think it's Amazon or eBay, for a well low price. So this is a stove that you can bring with you on hikes, and you can use it for cook your food. My solo stove, and this is the stove I used most times. I've used this for many years, and I really love this little stove. I think it's really cool and awesome, and very compact. And this is the Titan model, and when you buy this, I have bought a pot with it, with a lid, and it's It doesn't take much room. And the most cool thing about solar stove is there is a bottom, so there won't be anything that will drop down on the ground and can start a fire. And the other thing is this is isolated. That means that even if it has burned for a long time, a big fire, you can still take it like this and move it around without burning your fingers. So this part of the stove won't be so hot that you can't touch it, and neither will the bottom, so you can safely put it on the ground. Even if this is a very dry ground, it won't at night the ground, because it's well, it's not cold, but it's not very hot down here. So the cons about these stoves, and the reason why I'm not using that at the moment, is because when you lit it, it's only have a little flame, and you don't have the same feeling as with the essential bushcraft bush box. So when I'm sitting next to this, I don't have the same feeling of a little bonfire. This is very efficient. It can cook water very fast, and even cook your food, your meal very fast. And it's a very all-round and good little stove, and very compact too. The cons is that it's not cheap, not as cheap as this one. Some people will say it's a little bit expensive, but I think it's worth the money. And if you're looking for a stove that is clean and you can handle it, and the other things I was talking about, this is a good solution for you. I can strongly recommend you to buy this little stove from Solo. And this is the Titan. They make it a smaller one, and I think they also made some other sizes now. This is some years ago I bought this. And then of course I have my little wood stove here that I can heat up my shelter and cook my food on top of this. And this is from Worktop Stove, a great company. And for all my subscribers that have asked me when can I buy this, I say go into their website and see. I think now you can order these stoves. It's a wonderful stove. I really like it a lot. It's very compact, and well, it lights up very easily. So this is a big stove. You can not bring it on hikes unless you are perhaps in the winter and you have a pulk or something. My intention was to use it as a heating source in my Polish lava, and perhaps I do that sometime. But until now I use it inside my shelter, and it's really cool. Now I'm going to use it as a cooking stove. I will boil my water so I can get my coffee. Yeah, and look at this. This is my new kuksa that I have carved from the burl that I got from Signa Force. And you can see it's a very different design that I used to make. I made it more flat this way, and the reason for that is that I could write Kimber here with runes, Kimber on the side. I think it's really cool, and I'm very pleased with the shape that it has got. It's the big moment where I'm going to pour my coffee in this for the first time, very hot water, and there is a risk that this will crack, and I would like you to witness if it does and if it doesn't. I'm not quite sure because I cut this very thin on the sides and even on the bottom, so perhaps when I come my hot coffee in here, I will see that it'll crack. So you will be the first person that will see me using this and see if it holds. It's almost boiling now. Yeah, now it's boiling. Can you imagine the smell of fresh coffee here? It's so nice here in my Kimber camp, in my new shelter. It is so great. I really enjoy it a lot. And in a moment, you'll see if my new cookser can stand the heat from almost boiling water. I'm a little bit excited. It's a big moment. I've never had a cookser that cracked before when I pull hot water in it for the first time, but everything can happen, and I actually never had a cookser that it was so thin. So cross your fingers. Here we go. And again. This is not for the crack. Let's see. Does it hold? It seems to. I haven't heard anything. I don't know if it's going to say crack, but until now, nothing has happened. Nope. Then it's time for my whiskey. Nice big cup of coffee with whiskey in. Skål. It holds a lot of coffee, this cup. I love it. I think it's really cool. When I come home, I can take these and put on here. I didn't want to do that because I was not sure if this will work, but now I can see it's so good, and I really love the color of this Kuxa. You can see the difference between ordinary birch wood and birch wood from a barrel. It says another color. More warm, more red, and I just love it. So these are going on when I come back home. And perhaps you were interested in just see what I have on my Kuxa. I have a bear claw and a bear tooth from a good friend over in Canada, Hunt Shark Wilderness Experience, I think it's called. Paul here, he has sent me these things and other things many months ago. And this little Thor's hammer that I bought on a Viking market last summer. Many of you asked me where can I find this, but this is handmade from a blacksmith on the market, and I haven't been able to find it on the website or something. So this is mine, and some pearls and so on. And this is going to come on my new Kuxa. Yeah, and I decided to make a new thing on my channel. I'll call it Shout Out of the Month. It means that once a month I find a YouTube channel, I think it will be a bushcraft channel, and I will make a shout out for that channel. It shall be a channel that I think is cool and that I will recommend to you. There's some nice footage and some good ideas in it. And so this first shout out and this month, February, will be to a Danish YouTuber, a Danish bushcraft YouTuber called Martin, and he has a channel called Northern Woodsman DK. And he has asked me if I would like to tell you a little bit about his channel. He's a nice guy here in Denmark. I think he's living in the same area as I do in the northern part of Denmark. If not, then I'm sorry, Martin, but I think you are from this area. And he makes, he's just started making movies, videos on YouTube. He has a big Instagram channel, and now he's trying to gain some subscribers on YouTube. So I think you should go in and check him out. Of course, I'll put a link below so you can find his channel. He's not speaking much, and mostly in Danish, but not much, so you can easily understand what's going on. And he has some text with English, so you can read that and understand what he's doing. Go and check him out, Nonna Woodsman, DK I think it's called, and see if something is interesting for you on that channel.
Yeah, got a little more firewood, still have a lot. It's very very dense to chop in, so it takes a long time, but now I have a little storage that I can use when I'm in my camp.
Wow, that was hard work, I tell you. Those logs are really dense, a lot of hardwood inside, at least it felt like that. So it take a long time for me to process my firewood, but I got a lot of exercise doing that. Thank you for watching Kimmer Bushcraft. I hope you like my little video about the stoves in my series Bushcraft from A to Z. And perhaps you have got some good ideas or a recommendation for which one you are going to buy. I hope you found it interesting. Thank you again for watching Kimmer Bushcraft. I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.